So we go out and take our fuel moisture readings so that we have an idea of how much moisture is in our fuel, so that when we burn, we have an idea of the intensity that it's going to burn at.
And this basically has little teeth in there and it grinds all our leaves up into finer chunks.
Now we've got to select our type, so our type of fuel that we're assessing. So we go to type, and that gives us our list, and we're doing brown eucalypt, so number 4. Perfect. All right. Now we screw this on, and this compacts all the fuel down. And then when I press sample, it sends electronic pulse through. And we do this 3 times, and then average it out to get our fuel moisture levels. So what we're looking for is the numbers to fall within a prescription. So the prescription that we aim for is approximately in between 9 and 16% fuel moisture content. And we aim for that because it's the most ideal for a burn that will burn continuous, but not at a high intensity. So if we're getting fuel moisture sort of below that 9%, we'll have a very high intensity flame burn. Whereas if we have fuel moisture content above that 16 and way above that 16, the burn won't actually burn as intense as we need to and remove that fuel. So there's other prescriptions that we look for. So not only do we do our fuel moisture content, but we also have to have parameters for our temperature, our relative humidity, our wind speed, and also sometimes our rainfall. So if those parameters are too high a temperature or too stronger winds, or our fuel moisture content is too low, we won't go ahead with the burn and we'll just reschedule for times where those parameters are in check.